Good morning, everybody, and welcome to episode 84. I'm Barry Pierce. The time is 5 minutes to 11 o'clock on a grey Saturday morning here. And it's going to be a storm this afternoon and a few showers and a top of 26 degrees. Well, after a beautiful run of sunny weather, it is drawn to a close. And to tell us more about that, good morning to my offsided kit. Welcome to episode 84.
Thank you, Verifier. It's always good to be back to the studio. It's great. Like Barry say, today is not going to be a good day, especially the weather. But hey, we've got to enjoy it because, you know, it's only the rain and storm. But yeah, I'm going to talk to you guys. Well, yeah, it's good to see you all.
Well, today on episode 84, we're going to be talking about the importance of behaving at sporting matches, but we will get to that in a minute. So before I do get onto that, I'd just like to thank you all for tuning into the video that I've done over the past couple of months, and we'd like to know how 2020 has treated you. Here's my upsider for his opening view on how 2020 has treated him.
I know. 2020 is always, this year, quite a year. Very hard for loads of people, especially people that don't see their family much because of the pandemic. Really hard for everybody, especially sport, like Barry say, you know. Today, this week is going to be a week full of sport, of the grand final and all that. But please, we will talk to you guys how to behave publicly, behave in a sport match.
So, which brings me on to our opening, which brings us, I should say, onto my opening segment today. Behaving in public if you do attend a sports match. Don't spoil the game for everyone else because your team is losing, and don't have too much to drink. Here's my upsider to open the show with that.
Yep. This week, today, is a great start of the grand final of AFL. Like Barry said, please go to the game and enjoy the game, you know. Use the appropriate language when you speak or cheer for your team. You got to remember everybody there with their family, their kids, watch the game. Please be respectful of other people and be mindful. There's kids around in the footy in the grand final.
So if you are planning to go, okay, drive safely to the match. Here's my upside.
Yeah, you've got to be planning your day, especially today. If you think that you're going to drive, please don't touch any alcohol. Or if you think you're going to catch the public holiday, public transport, please be watchful and be mindful that you're going to get there early.
And pack some lunch if you are going to, or dinner. Here's my upside.
Yeah, if you want to buy dinner there, or if you want to take lunch or dinner, pack it properly, you know, and if some water you take with you. And yeah, That's what you got to do.
And have enough money to get a taxi home from the venue as well. Here's my offside.
Yep. You got to be prepared. Finance and food and drink. Make sure you are you there to support your team and enjoy it.
And like we say, if you go to the cricket and the game starts at 10 o'clock in the morning, leave home at about 6:30 because you need enough time to get to the game, because if you are in Melbourne and if you are in another part of Victoria, like Shepparton, you need to leave Shepparton at least a couple of hours early. Here's my offside.
Yeah, it depends where you live. You got to think about, like they say, you know, if you live far away from the city where the game is, you got to plan a day ahead. You got a big trip today to take. But yeah, you got to be careful when you drive. Extra careful.
And remember, allow time yourself enough time, because there could be traffic on the expressways and freeways and highways. Here's my offside.
Yeah, that's right. You got to be, you know, plenty of time in the freeway to get there to the games, because you know the queue up in the door. You gotta be careful when you go.
And make sure that you have your GPS with you so that you know the best routes to take to get to the MCG or the SCG or the Gabba, the Adelaide Oval, the Wacker in Perth, Blue Steel Stadium in Hobart, or Bell Reef Oval in Hobart, and the Adelaide Oval. Here's my offside.
Yep, that's what you do. Thank you, Barry, for mentioning about GPS. Because this is a very, very, very important thing that you put your map there to take you to the game, whatever the stadium, because there's a lot of stadium in Melbourne. You got to know where to go.
And the same if you go to the cricket at the MCG or the SCG, the Gabba in Brisbane, the Adelaide Oval in Adelaide, the Wacker Ground in Perth, Bell Reeve Oval, you name it, and even North Sydney Oval or Bankstown Oval. Here's my offside.
Yeah, that's a very important point that Barry bringing up for you, though.
And when you get to the game, please have your tickets and your money ready. Here's my offside.
Yeah, that's what you do. You got to get your ticket ready, money ready, get in, enjoy the game, don't be a fool.
And think about the other spectators as well. Here's my offside.
Yeah, you got to think about it. Yeah, that's very important. But,
and if you have someone in a wheelchair, upgrade their wheelchair access at the SCG, the MCG, the Gabba, the Adelaide Oval in Adelaide, the Wacker Ground in Perth, Subiaco Oval in Perth, Bell Reef, North Sydney Oval, and Banks down over. He's my offsider.
Yeah. Watch the footy, cricket, that's all just him that Barry mentioned. You got to know where to go.
And the wheelchair access.
And the wheelchair access. It's always there. It's always there. It's available for the wheelchair. Heaps of wheelchair.
And also make sure when you ring up these places that they've got accessible bathrooms there too. Here's my offsider.
Yep. That's a lot of access bathrooms with a wheelchair and public and everybody.
And make sure that you ring the accessible bus company to find out what time the first bus leaves your area in the morning so that you can get your disabled son or daughter ready for the day. Here's my offsider.
Yep, that is so true. Listen to Barry, guys. You're not going to be lost.
And make sure that you have an Opal card as well to tap on and off when you get on or off the bus. Here's my offsider.
Yep, that's right.
So planning your day to go to the football or cricket, make sure that you've got enough food or drinks to cover yourself and for the person who you are assisting. Here's my offsider.
Yeah, that's the thing, you know, especially if you take someone in a wheelchair with you, you gotta be prepared, and then, you know, you gotta know where the exit, and you gotta know the closest, you know, to the bathroom and things like that for the wheelchair.
And if someone has medication, guys, make sure you have their folders too. Here's my offsider.
Yep. Make sure you got everything from food, from, you know, that's just everything for your kind if you take them in wheelchair. Okay.
And make sure you've got your mobile phone and that it is charged. Here's my offsider.
Yeah. Make sure you cover all that, you know. And then your going to the game will be comfortable.
If a medical emergency arises, if you are out, make sure that you call an ambulance straight away. Here's my offsider.
Yeah, that's when you call the ambulance. If you have an incident with the client, that's when you call the ambulance.
Okay, and also you make sure that you contact the health manager as well, and inform them of what's happened. Here's my offsider.
Yeah, that's what you do. Follow the policy of your company. You gotta call the ambulance, and then you inform your manager what's going on and what's happened, and then you go from there.
So what would you do, kid, say, if I was out with you? And I needed to call an ambulance.
I will call the ambulance first, and then when they're on the way, I will call the house manager and inform, and then I'll write the incident report, what's happening, document everything, what happened, and then, like, you go to the hospital with your client.
So if you are calling emergency services to, say, like the FCG, the the GABA, the Adelaide Oval, the MCG, anywhere. Give me above address of the venue and the nearest cross street. Give my offside.
Yeah, you need to have a right information. You tell the ambulance so they can come direct, because MCC is a big space, big places. But if you know the gate and the number of the area you at, just tell the ambulance, and then they will come straight there.
And make sure you tell the ambulance where and best at the venues like the SCG or the ANZ Stadium, because these places are really big. Keep my offer.
Yeah. It's really, really complicated if you say, oh, I'm in the stadium, and they will say, what stadium? That's when you give the right info.
Because for all they know, it could be AMZ Stadium, when really it was Bankwest Stadium. And then thinking, where the hell is that?
That's right.
Here's my offside.
Yep. Direct, simple, clear message to the ambo, and that, like, no confusion.
Well, to close the show today, behaving responsibly, okay, at the grand final tonight and tomorrow, don't go boo because somebody's done something, like make a mistake. Here's my offside.
Yeah, every game will be a lot of mistake, but like Barry say, that's right. You just, you know, there to watch the game, support your game, support your team. Don't go and boo people in the game. Just make sure. Respect.
And it's important, guys, another thing we forgot to mention, ask what time the bus leaves the stadium to get back into your area. Here's my offside.
You gotta find out the time, because you don't wanna stop in there all day, all night, you know? Got to make sure you know the time the bus is leaving or the train. Make sure it's very clear that you know the time you get.
And you may have to swap buses as well. In my offside.
Yeah, you might go in there and then you take the bus and then you swap or whatever. But you gotta know the time.
And make sure that you know your bus routes to and from the stadium, guys, and what time the bus gets back to your area, and just going over, behaving responsibly. Don't be a fool, because you will be evicted from the ground, the stadium or the MCG or SCG, whatever's been played there. So go there. Behave yourself and don't drink and drive. Here's my offside.
Yeah, that's a very important thing, you know. Don't drink and drive, guys.
We hope that you've enjoyed today's topic on behaving at sporting matches and how to get there. One time to leave home, and you may have to leave the game early to get home because there could be traffic going back on the expressways or freeways. Here's my offside for his closing message.
Yep. Thank you all for listening to us and watching our very fierce video episode. Hopefully we'll see you guys very soon. We'll catch up soon.
And remember, take your time in getting to the game. There's no rush in the same getting home. Have plenty of patience, guys. Here's my operator to take us out with that message.
Yeah.
And his comment.
That's right. You know, you got to be patient. Take a lot of patience, but, you know, you got to take it easy on the road. Drive safe. You know, don't drink drive. Enjoy your weekend and the grand final weekend. Hope you have a great weekend.
And remember the message that we end each video with. Don't bring 000 unless you've got an emergency. We always close each episode with that. Here's my upside with that message and farewell now.
Yep. And that's what you do, guys, you know. Remember to be stay safe on the weekend and hope you have a great week. And please, 000, we encourage you all. Please don't call 000 for any reason. Only reason you call 000, if you have a
medical emergency or car crash or someone's been assaulted, but no trivial issues, please. Okay? We'd like you to have a great weekend and we'll catch up with you on the next episode. This has been episode 84 and hopefully this video will give you and your family some useful tips when going to sporting matches. And on that note, time to say good morning to you now and have a great Saturday. Here's my upside.
Yeah. Please have a great weekend and stay safe and don't be a fool. Use appropriate language in the game. Make sure respectful is the key. And thank you all for watching us today on episode 84 from Barry Fear Production.
And episode 85 coming up in a couple of days' time. A couple of days' time. And this one is about how I put YouTube videos together. And watch out for that video when it comes. But until then, guys, have a great weekend, and I will see you in a couple of days. Have a great Saturday, everybody, and take care. Good morning, everyone, and here's my offsider.
All right, see you all, and good morning, and goodbye.
And good morning, Thomas. Have a great day.